This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Norman Podhoretz, PDHRTZ, born January 16, 1930, is an American neoconservative pundit and writer for Commentary Magazine. Contents 1. Early life. 2. Career. 3. Political views. 31. American history. 32. Iraq. 33. Iran. 34. Vietnam. 35. Soviet Union. 36. George W. Bush. 37. Sarah Palin. 4 books. 5. Further reading. 51. Primary sources. 6. See also. 7. References. 8. External links. Early life. The son of Julius and Helen Wolliner Podhoretz, Jewish immigrants from the Central European region of Galicia, part of Poland at the time, now geographically Ukraine. Podhoretz was born and raised in Brownsville, Brooklyn. Podhoretz's family was leftist, with his elder sister joining a socialist youth movement. He attended Boys High School in the borough's Bedford-Stuyvesant neighborhood, ultimately graduating third in his class in 1946. His classmates included the prominent Assyriologist William W. Hello and advertising executive Carl Spielvogel. Admitted to Harvard University and New York University with partial tuition scholarships, Podhoretz ultimately elected to attend Columbia University after receiving a full Pulitzer scholarship in 1950. Podhoretz received his BA degree in English Literature from Columbia, where he was mentored by Lionel Trilling. He concurrently earned a second bachelor's degree in Hebrew Literature from the nearby Jewish Theological Seminary of America. Although Podhoretz never intended to enter the rabbinate, his father, who only attended synagogue on the high holidays, wanted to ensure that his son was nonetheless conversant in the intellectual tradition of his people as a non-observant New World Jew who treasured the Hebraic tradition. After being awarded the Kellett Fellowship and a Fulbright Scholarship, he later received a second BA in Literature with first-class honors and an MA from Clare College, Cambridge, where he briefly pursued doctoral studies after rejecting a graduate fellowship from Harvard. He also served in the United States Army 1953-1955 as a draftee assigned to U.S. Army Security Agency. Career. Podhoretz served as Commentary Magazine's editor-in-chief from 1960, when he replaced Elliot E. Cohen, until his retirement in 1995. Podhoretz remains Commentary's editor-at-large in 1960. He wrote the essay, My Negro Problem, and Ours, in which he described the oppression he felt from African Americans as a child, and concluded by calling for a color-blind society, and advocated the wholesale merging of the two races, the most desirable alternative for everyone concerned. From 1981 to 1987, Podhoretz was an advisor to the U.S. Information Agency from 1995 to 2003. He was a senior fellow at the Hudson Institute. He was awarded the Presidential Medal of Freedom by George W. Bush in 2004. The award recognized Podhoretz's intellectual contributions as editor-in-chief of Commentary Magazine and as a senior fellow at the Hudson Institute. Podhoretz is married to author Midge Dechter, and is the father of syndicated columnist and current Commentary editor-in-chief John Podhoretz. He is the stepfather of Ruthie Bloom Leibowitz and the late Rachel Abrams née Dechter. Elliot Abrams' wife Norman Podhoretz was one of the original signatories of the Statement of Principles of the Project for the New American Century, founded in 1997. That organization sent a letter to President Clinton in 1998 advocating the removal by force of Saddam Hussein in Iraq. Podhoretz received the Guardian of Zion Award from Bar-Ilan University on May 24, 2007. He served as a senior foreign policy advisor to Rudy Giuliani in his 2008 presidential campaign. The same year, he publicly advocated an American attack on Iran. Podhoretz's 2009 book, Why Are Jews Liberals Questions Why American Jews for Decades Have Been Dependable Democrats, often supporting the party by margins of better than 2-1, even in years of Republican landslides. Political views. American history. Podhoretz has downplayed the importance of American history to his political beliefs. When Gore Vidal was writing his play On the March to the Sea, based on General William Tecumseh Sherman's March to the Sea during the U.S. Civil War, Podhoretz asked him, "Why are you writing a play about, of all things, the Civil War?" When Vidal explained that this was, is, the great, single tragic event that gives resonance to our republic, Podhoretz replied, "To me, the Civil War is as remote and irrelevant as the War of the Roses Iraq in the lead-up to the 2003 U.S. invasion of Iraq." Podhoretz argued strongly for military intervention, claiming that Saddam Hussein posed a direct threat to the United States after the 9/11 attack and more than a year before the start of the war in Iraq. Podhoretz wrote in February 2002 that there is no doubt that Saddam already possesses large stores of chemical and biological weapons, and may be on the precipice of nuclear power. Some urge that we concentrate on easier targets first. Others contend that the longer we wait, the more dangerous Saddam will grow. Yet whether or not Iraq becomes the second front in the war against terrorism, one thing is certain: there can be no victory in this war if it ends with Saddam Hussein still in power. Iran in 2007, Podhoretz argued that the United States should attack Iranian nuclear facilities. According to the Sunday Times, Podhoretz believes that Iraq, Afghanistan and Iran are merely different fronts of the same long war. Podhoretz describes diplomatic efforts with Iran as similar to appeasement of Nazi Germany prior to World War II. He also contends that the war on terror is a war against Islamofascism, and constitutes World War IV, World War III having been the Cold War, and advocates the bombing of Iran to preempt Iranian acquisition of nuclear weapons. His book on that subject, entitled World War IV, The Long Struggle Against Islamofascism, was published by Doubleday on September 11, 2007. In a more recent article, Podhoretz explicitly stated his view that Iran should be attacked. In short, the plain and brutal truth is that if Iran is to be prevented from developing a nuclear arsenal, there is no alternative to the actual use of military force. He then went on to consider the consequences of bombing Iran. The opponents of bombing, not just the usual suspects but many who have no illusions about the nature and intentions and potential capabilities of the Iranian regime, disagree that it might end in the overthrow of the mullahocracy. On the contrary, they are certain that all Iranians, even the democratic dissidents, would be impelled to rally around the flag, and this is only one of the worst-case scenarios they envisage, to wit, Iran would retaliate by increasing the trouble it is already making for us in Iraq. It would attack Israel with missiles armed with non-nuclear warheads but possibly containing biological and/or chemical weapons. There would be a vast increase in the price of oil, with catastrophic consequences for every economy in the world, very much including our own. The worldwide outcry against the inevitable civilian casualties would make the anti-Americanism of today look like a love fest. I readily admit that it would be foolish to discount any or all of these scenarios. Each of them is, alas, only too plausible. Nevertheless, there is a good response to them, and it is the one given by John McCain. The only thing worse than bombing Iran, McCain has declared, is allowing Iran to get the bomb Vietnam. In an editorial to the Wall Street Journal on the sixth anniversary of the September 11th attacks, Podhoretz contends that the retreat from Iraq should not be similar to the retreat from Vietnam. He argues that when the U.S. withdrew from Vietnam, it sacrificed its national honor in 1982. James Fallows wrote a review of Podhoretz's book, Why We Were in Vietnam, for the New York Times, in which he accuses Podhoretz of changing his views and self-righteousness on the subject of Vietnam, noting that in 1971 Podhoretz wrote that he would prefer just such an American defeat to a Vietnamization of the war. A larger quote from Why We Were in Vietnam, which was included in the review, is as follows: as one who has never believed that anything good would ever come for us or for the world from an unambiguous American defeat, I now find myself, and here is the main source of my own embarrassment in writing about Vietnam, unhappily moving to the side of those who would prefer just such an American defeat to a Vietnamization of the war, which calls for the indefinite and unlimited bombardment by American pilots in American planes of every country in that already devastated region. Soviet Union in the early 1980s, Podhoretz was extremely skeptical that fundamental reform was possible in the USSR, and sharply criticized those who argued that U.S. policy toward the Soviet Union should be one of détente. In his 1980 book The Present Danger, Podhoretz predicted that the United States was in danger of losing the Cold War and falling behind the Soviet Union as a global power. Later he would express anger with President Ronald Reagan for not establishing sufficiently strong policies toward the Soviets. George W. Bush. Podhoretz has praised Bush, calling him a man who knows evil when he sees it and who has demonstrated an unfailingly courageous willingness to endure vilification and contumely in setting his face against it. He calls Bush the president who was battered more mercilessly and with less justification than any other in living memory. Sarah Palin. In a Wall Street Journal editorial titled In Defense of Sarah Palin, Podhoretz wrote, I hereby declare that I would rather be ruled by the Tea Party than by the Democratic Party, and I would rather have Sarah Palin sitting in the Oval Office than Barack Obama. Books 1963, Hannah Arendt on Eichmann, A Study in the Perversity of Brilliance. New York, American Jewish Committee 1964, Doings and Undoings, The 50s and After in American Writing. New York, Farrar. Strauss Collection of Essays 1964, My Negro Problem and Ours. New York, American Jewish Committee 1966, The Commentary Reader, Two Decades of Articles and Stories, New York, Athenaeum Editor Collection of Essays 1967, Making It. New York, Random House Autobiography. ISBN 0-394-43449-8, 1967, Jewishness. D.C., National Center for Legislative Research 1984, State of World Jury Address, 1983. New York. Foundation 2007, World War IV, The Long Struggle Against Islamofascism. New York, Doubleday, ISBN 0-385-52221-5, 2009, Why Are Jews Liberals. New York, Doubleday, ISBN 0-385-52919-8. Further reading. Abrams, Nathan Norman. Podhoretz and Commentary Magazine, The Rise and Fall of the Neocons, Continuum, 2010. Balint, Benjamin. Running Commentary, The Contentious Magazine That Transformed the Jewish Left into the Neoconservative Right. Public Affairs, 2010. Bloom, Alexander. Prodigal Sons, The New York Intellectuals, 1981. See also Conservatism Portal. Life Against Death. References. Carrot Commentary Magazine. Carrot Independent. Cook. Carrot Norman. Podhoretz, NNDB. Carrot Contemporary Literary Criticism, Norman Podhoretz. Carrot Podhoretz, L. Jeffers, Norman, Thomas. December 30, 2003. The Norman Podhoretz Reader, a selection of his writings from the 1950s through the 1990s. First Ed. Free Press. P. Secretary, June 18, 2004. Carrot Herita. George. Carrot Carrot Giuliani's War Cabinet. The American Prospect, September 25, 2007. Carrot His Toughness Problem, and Ours, by Ian Baruma. Carrot Norman Podhoretz, Jewish Conservative, asks, Why Are Jews Liberals? Carrot Pettifer, and December 14, 2002. Zionism Unbound, Counterpunch. Carrot A. B. Podhoretz N., In Praise of the Bush Doctrine, Commentary Magazine, September 2002. Carrot Podhoretz N., How to Win World War IV, Commentary Magazine, February 2002. Carrot Baxter, Sarah, Neocon Godfather. Norman Podhoretz Tells Bush, Bomb Iran. The Sunday Times, September 30, 2007. Carrot Podhoretz N., The Case for Bombing Iran. The Wall Street Journal, May 30, 2007. Accessed May 30, 2007. Carrot ABC, The Case for Bombing Iran, Commentary Magazine, last accessed November 26, 2007. Carrot Podhoretz N., America the Ugly, The Wall Street Journal, September 11, 2007. Accessed September 11, 2007. Carrot Fallows, James, In Defense of an Offensive War. The New York Times, March 28, 1982. Accessed January 3, 2008. Carrot Norman Podhoretz, The Present Danger, New York, Simon. Podhoretz N., World War IV, How It Started, What It Means, and Why We Have to Win, Commentary Magazine. Com, September 2004. Rago J., Unrepentant Neocon, Norman Podhoretz Stands IV Square for the Bush Doctrine, Wall Street Journal, August 12, 2006. Podhoretz N., The Case for Bombing Iran, The Wall Street Journal, May 30, 2007. A film clip, The Open Mind, The Present Danger, Soviet Imperialism 1980, is available at the Internet Archive. A film clip, The Open Mind, The Future Danger, Totalitarianism 1981, is available at the Internet Archive. VE Neoconservatism, General Democratization, Globalization, Humanitarian Intervention, Liberal Internationalism, Bush Doctrine. Pax Americana. Figures. William Crystal. Robert Kagan. Frederick Kagan. Irving Crystal. Paul Wolfowitz. Richard Pearl. John R. Bolton. Charles Krauthammer. David Frum. Elliot Abrams. Norman Podhoretz. David Wormser. Douglas J. Faith. Paul Bremer. Peter Berkowitz. Douglas Murray. David Aronovich. Oliver Cam. Max Boot. Elliot A. Cohen. Gene Kirkpatrick. Michael Novak. Jonah Goldberg. Joshua Muravchik. Jennifer Rubin. Erwin Stelzer. Brett Stevens. Zalmay Khalilzad. Scooter Libby. Yuval Levin. James Kirchick. Major Influences. Leo Strauss. Bernard Lewis. Henry M. Jackson. Organizations. Project for the New American Century. National Endowment for Democracy. Foundation for Defense of Democracies. Jewish Institute for National Security Affairs. Henry Jackson Society. Houston Group. Emergency Committee for Israel. Hudson Institute. American Enterprise Institute. Foreign Policy Initiative. NGO Monitor. Publications. Commentary. The Weekly Standard. The Public Interest. Frontpage Magazine. National Affairs Encounter related articles. Timeline of modern American conservatism. Neoconservatism and paleoconservatism. British neoconservatism. Blairism and New Labour. Clash of civilizations. Idealism in international relations. Liberal hawk. Anti-Stalinist left. The New York intellectuals and Trotskyism. Republican in name only. Pejorative. Cuckservative. Pejorative. Stop Trump movement. Authority control. WorldCat identities. VIAF 3,271,796 LCCM N8113917. ISNI 0000-0001-2098-624-XGND, 119,024,063 Sudik, 0310241300-B, N, F, CB 12,232,213's data.